And so far, I have to commend the media for a yeoman's job over the years since 1992, when elections were conducted in this country. Unlike some other African countries where the media has caused mayhem, leading to genocide and others, we have been lucky in Ghana to experience none of those things. Coming with the experience that I had in the United Nations and other things, traveling for peacekeeping missions, and the experience that we went through, even sometimes losing our lives, ourselves, our colleagues losing their lives, I have to commend the media in Ghana once again for the good job that they've been doing to prevent these occurrences in our midst. And to share with you a little security provisions that the police have made within the region to ensure that everybody is safe during the elections coming 7 December this year. The police are certain sessions that we have created. One is the polling stations. Then we have the collation centers, both at the constituency level and then the regional level. Besides that, there have been certain bodies that has also been created to take up security issues. One, we have provided security for each polling station within the region. And in certain circumstances where we envisage a place to be a flashpoint, two security officers are made available there. And I'm using security because it is not only the police who is covering these areas. We will be overwhelmed if we do that ourselves. So in view of that, all the sister security services, which the police service, the immigration service, customs, fire service, are all involved. And everything that has been planned has been done with a team, including all the regional commands, the divisional commands, the district commands, the unit commanders of all these units, depending on the role that you are supposed to play. And so with the police stations, every police station is covered. And then number two, we have provisions 24 hours for the collation centers. And these collation centers are headed by senior officers, either from the police or any other security services, from the rank of ASP and its equivalent in any of these security services. Besides that, we have men, and provisions is made for 7 days, just in case there is any problem. The police and the security other services will stay on for 7 days so that we ensure that there's absolute peace before we disperse our men. We also have what we call the JOC, the Joint Operation Centers, at the regional level, the divisional level, and then the district level. These, in the regional level, the members of this JOC are these, the Regional Security Council members. And we do this in collaboration with the ECs. And in the likewise, we, the municipal security councils from the district and the divisional level also hold the same JOC, where they receive information from everybody, including the media, on matters that poses threats to the elections. And not only that, but any other security concern. Apart from that, we also have responsive teams, which are the operational response teams. These are various designated patrol made available for every constituency. And where constituencies have extended areas, we provide more than a vehicle for that responsive patrols. And these are some of the measures put across. And besides that, the JOCs, the Joint Security Councils, have vehicles available for them to move occasionally in teams. Some will be at the base, some will move out to the polling stations to observe for themselves what is going on at these polling stations. And lastly, all police security services partaking in these elections have been oriented, like the EC just enumerated to you, the role of the, how do you call it, the media, all the police have been oriented in a way other than the previous years that we have experienced. Because to us, every occasion is unique. We never measure one occasion to the other. So we see it as a different, because all of us here can see the system that we are today and the way things are going between the political parties, heckling here and there. So we are not taking anything for granted. We are not leaving any stone unturned. We are going to be there full. And so what we need is that we also need the media to support us by quickly giving us information before anything escalates. So this is shortly what the police has done. And therefore, we expect the police, the media, to cooperate with us as security of our bodies, just as you do same with the EC. We expect you to cooperate with us. Give us information. Do not interrupt with activities of the security officers. When you have any issue, please deal with the commands and not members on the ground. If you go to the ground and you see a policeman misbehave, quickly call the command sectors and then you give us information for us to move in. We have also made suggestions because, you know, the layouts in Ghana are so difficult that it becomes difficult tracking areas in case of emergencies. So we have made suggestions to the command that all the numbers that we provided should make it WhatsApp, well, so that locations can be forwarded into this, how do you call it, our command centers. So when movements is going to be done by any of these responsive teams, these things will be forwarded to them to quickly enable them to track the exact location where these things are occurring. So far, that is what the police have done in terms of these coming elections.